are in our hotel. We're gonna be doing the same thing. We're going to be doing your makeup so the director can just do a few pictures to check for the light. Will that be okay? Yes, okay. So I wanted to show you a few things before we get started. I wanted to show you that the wallpaper in our room is spongy. I don't know if you can see that. You can push it in, and that's to help absorb sound in these old buildings. So I have the wet look going on here as my hair is wet. And I wish I could say it was because I was in a pool today, but it's just because I took a shower. So let's go ahead and start with some moisturizer. You know, this is one of your favorite moisturizers. So we'll go ahead and start down here in your room. But the director wants us to finish upstairs on the balcony that overlooks the caves where the people used to live. Did you go to the cistern today? Isn't it an amazing thing? The cistern, I guess they made, that's Palombaro Lungo, and that was the largest cistern in the city. But they made a lot of cisterns here. So let me go ahead. On your cheeks. Can you feel me wipe that on your cheek? And on the other cheek. Can we do the other cheek? Can you feel me wipe? Yeah, okay, so now I'm just gonna rub it in a little bit. Sorry, I have an itchy ear. I'm just gonna rub that in. Rub it in on your cheeks. And I have a little bit extra on my hands. I'm just gonna wipe it all over. Just gonna wipe it gently. Very good. I use the rest for me. So I know that this is going to be a spaghetti western, but I also know that it's going to be a very strange spaghetti western, and I know that you're going to be attacked by a bunch of robots from outer space. So it's both a western and a sci-fi. And here's what one of your robots looks like. They sent one over. Here's a robot that's in the box. Can you see him? Isn't he cute? He is a steampunk robot. I have some moisturizer for your eyes. I think we should do a little bit of moisturizer on your eyes. What do you think? Right here. Right there. You have that one hair. Can you come a little bit closer? Just let me push that hair out of your way. Very good. Yeah. So we spent the last couple days here in Matera, and James Bond filmed the opening sequence to No time to die, I think. Here. And he rode his motorcycle along the rooftops of, they call them the Sassy, but they're really the caves in the rocks. Just putting it on your eye. I'm gonna put it, I'm gonna sweep it on gently. 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 And also on your other eye. So it's finally warmed up here in Italy. Gently. 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 And it's actually pretty sweltering out there right now. It's about 87 degrees, which is too hot for me. So that's why I wanted to do the first part. But for some reason, he wants me to do the eye makeup. Upstairs. So since we're just doing the pictures and he wants them to look more natural, I'm not gonna put on a primer. I'm just gonna go ahead. Oh, you got a little spot right there. I'm just gonna wipe that gently. Gently, gently, gently. So there we go. So I'm gonna put on a little bit of foundation. Really sunny out, we'll go ahead and use this foundation, which has an SPF of 20. It makes a lovely tapping noise, doesn't it? So let me just go ahead and put this on you. On your left cheek. And on your chin right there. And on your forehead. Excellent. Just rub those in it. Rub, rub, rub it. In a nice circular motion. And just go rub it. I definitely need to buff it in, so let me go get a brush. Okay, so I just need to buff. Do you mind if I buff mine in real quick? Things in. So yeah, we've been in Matera for 2 days, and Matera was a place that has been continuously inhabited for 13,000 years. It's the oldest continuously inhabited city in Europe, and it wasn't until 1950 when the last people left the caves. Getting dry, that's helpful. Okay, so how about if we sweep just the tiniest bit of color on your cheeks? What do you think? Yeah, we can do that. Okay. beautiful. We've really enjoyed walking around, seeing all the sassy, seeing all the homes that people lived in right up until the 1950s. And it was called, the people living in these caves were very indigent. And it was called the shame of Italy that in 1950, in such a progressive year, that they still had people living like that. So, how about this blush right here? We've really enjoyed our stay. Some of the things we haven't enjoyed so much about Southern Italy, though, to be honest, are all the homeless companion animals. And some that we've seen have been in just dire straits. And nobody, where we were in Ostuni, nobody even bothered to put out fresh water for them. Like, how big of a deal would that be to put out extra water when you see, I mean, cats with kittens, super scrawny kittens. But I don't want to talk about that because I don't want to stress you out. And, you know, I'll have to assess the situation when I get here, but all these animals are intact. They're not even spaying and neutering. So it's just, to me, it's ridiculous. But that's not the way a first world country should behave. Everything else about Italy has been wonderful. So, do you mind if I gently put some on me? Gently sweep it on me. So gently. Let me try it on you. Sweep it, sweep it, sweep it. And then try it again on me. Sweep, sweep, sweep. How is that? You come a little bit closer. There we go. I'll just come and sweep it gently on your nose. Gently, gently. And on your nose. Okay, so we can also do the highlighter here. Very pale. It's just gonna brighten up your cheeks a little bit, so we'll do it in that scene, kinda like this. Do you feel that? That feels so good. Let me try that on you. Try it on me, just a gentle scene. So the homeless animal situation could be improved. I think I've heard that all over Southern Italy and Central Italy too, that homeless animals are a huge problem. So again, I don't want to stress you out, and I wouldn't want to stop you from coming to this part of the world, even though Puglia used to be very poor. I think Puglia is not poor anymore. The houses go for 500 to 600,000, and they're not very big, but they are pretty nice, I would say. So, okay. So, that leaves just the eye colors to do. For now, we can just do the lashes and the lipstick. Are you ready for that? So, let me, oh, good. That looks great. So can we then do your lipstick? Okay. You just pucker up. Can you pucker up for me, please? Come a little bit closer. Don't do the upper part. Okay, nothing to do but the eyeshadow. Do that upstairs, right? Okay, here we are upstairs. I'm just gonna push your hair back. A little bit, yeah. Can you see Matera in the background? It's so beautiful. And I had to change my dress because I went to a restaurant with my husband, a bar, and we had bruschetta, and I got tomato parts all over my dress. So, we'll just do a little bit of eye makeup. Will that be okay? Yeah. You can kind of hear the crowd in the background. Let me just do a little bit of eyeshadow. We'll do the glittery eyeshadow like I have on. Do you see it? I just have on a little bit. Will that be okay? Can I come really close? Yeah. It's so beautiful. It was such a beautiful evening. It was actually pretty hot. This is on the edge of what I can tolerate. It got up to like 88 degrees. But it reverberates off of all the stones. And it's still very warm out. I think I would not visit the city in July and August. But that's just me. I know you have to work, so you come whenever. So how about, yeah, we'll just put this color on your eyelids for the... All my brushes, so I just have a Q-tip here to do this, and to do your other eye. That's... Yeah, and I'm gonna put the extra on myself if you don't mind. Oh yeah, so pretty, so sparkly. What do you think? A rooftop view. Let's go and look at the rest of it. Should we go look at the rest of it? Okay, yeah, I think you're all done. You look great. Let's go look at the rest of the view. Here. Such a beautiful evening. Are you going to be ready to go to sleep? I mean, look at that. Look at all the beautiful homes carved out of the limestone until they weren't allowed to live here. And now people are coming back. They're fixing up the homes. Some of them are absolutely beautiful, but most of them are still empty. Just houses carved out of the limestone. Absolutely beautiful. Yeah, I think the film's gonna be great. Now, I know you're gonna be down there, is where you're gonna be attacked by the robots. So yeah, I think that's gonna be pretty intense scene. We'll be ready for it, won't we? Awesome. Matera is awesome. We're down here in Puglia. Way down here. At kind of the arch of the heel of the boot for Italy.